charge up with the part, the charger cord. But anyways, this... I'm back. Okay, well, as we were finishing it up, the Book of Matthew, but this here, I recommend it, but it goes through the whole, what's going on, the Revelation, whole book, and about the Euphrates River. Says here the Euphrates River here about drying up, and the sea turns to blood. But there's some rivers turning to blood already. But I believe, well, it is seven signs, the signs of the times. So we'll probably get that Revelations here sometime, and. As I watch YouTube about they're talking about, a lot of them aren't talking about Revelations. And Revelations, I used to fear it too, but it's not to be feared. But anyways, we talked about up to Matthew 5 through 16. You know, bless you who will rebuild the persecuted you. Bless are you when they reveal and persecute you. And they say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my name's sake. So I'm all tongue-tied, I apologize. So, you know, today people, non-Christians are really evil. Even some non-Christians are all bad, but they're just like, hey, that is what it is. But today, where these people were, I don't know, it's getting bad out there. And when you, like I said, you talk about the Bible, but as soon as you bring Jesus Christ into the conversation, I've seen a lot of people get mad. A lot of people don't want to even talk about it. A lot of people think just totally, like, because they're mad at Jesus, because, well, if you love, you're a Christian, then Jesus loves, yeah, of course he loves everybody. And we're supposed to care and pray for this person that committed sin. It's the person, Jesus loves everybody. It's the sin he don't love. People just don't understand it. It's the commandments, you know. Like Brockman, I would watch him. He's a good person on YouTube. He tells it as it is. There's a couple other preachers, and they're just telling it as it is. It is what it is. And people do not want to listen to the Bible anymore. They don't care. And more and more people are falling away from the church, and falling away from the Bible, and not listening to the Bible. Well, I'm sorry, but I'm doing my best, because I don't want to spend my time in hell. I'm going to spend my time on this earth right now. So. I'm sorry, I'm all over the page, Bible and all this, but thank you for trying to bear with me, and I appreciate that. I should open up with prayer, but I'm going to close this with prayer. So, Lord, thank you for the knowledge. Give us strength, wisdom. Bless this new year coming in here in a few hours. Give us strength, wisdom. Watch over us. Watch over the weak, the meek. Give us strength. Be merciful on all of us. When you come, Lord, we know when. It's all in time. Tomorrow's not guaranteed. And help us prepare your time when you do come. And keep us ready. You know, help us keep an eye open for you, Lord. Keep us strong in your word. Keep our hearts pure for you. You know, and just keep us wise in your name, Lord. We got to keep strong in your love. And keep us, you know, keep us knowing that you're coming soon and we can't fall away from the cross, Lord. We can't fall away from you, Lord, because you're the only way it's going to be. You're the way, Lord. It's the only time. It's the only thing we could do, because we're going to, if we fall away, no one wants to spend eternal life in hell. But we want to spend eternal life with you, Lord. Everlasting life, not Hades and pain and burning and gnashing of teeth and eternal, you know, ever thirsting for water, because I just can't imagine, Lord, but this everlasting peace and no more pain and aches and crying and sadness, just being with you, Lord. We cannot wait until we see you, Lord. And Lord, and I apologize for not asking for guidance before I read these verses. And Lord, whoever subscribed and watching my videos, please bring the word to them in understanding, and bear with me and understand that I'm trying my best to do this. Bring them to understand that they need you, we need you, Lord. And the words I speak come through me, but by you through me, that are your words, and your words only. That it were to come out correct and that people understand that it is the word of God, and help us understand this word every day and open our hearts to your words and the scripture. And we pray for a prosperous new year, Lord. And with that, we ask this in Jesus' name, in his holy name, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. I'm just all tongue-tied today, and I apologize. But with that, thank you for watching my channel, Minister Bill channel. I'm going to change that, Minister Bill's channel, Minister Bill's scripture channel, Minister Bill's Bible channel. I'll figure it out. But thank you. Please subscribe, say your prayers, like, comment, and, the turning point, you can go davidjeremiah.org, you can check him out, turningpoint.com, you can get his, booklet every month. You get these like little pamphlets every month. I got overwhelmed and I got too many every month. I couldn't keep up with them, so I emailed them back and told them I have enough for right now, and I had to pass them out, so which is good. So turning point is P.O. Box 3838, San Diego, California 92163, or 800-947-1993, davidjeremiah.org, the turning point. I would, that's David Jeremiah, I would, check him out. It's really good. It's pretty good information. I'm not promoting this. It's just something I would look into. And he said that's a really good scripture. All right. God bless you. Happy New Year. And bless you. And we'll see you next time. See you next year.